ये मोह के धागे तेरी उंगलियों से जा उलझे, कोई तोह ना लागे किस तरह गिरहा ये सुलझे। है रोम रोम एक तारा, गजब का है दिन, सोचो
अलंकार
जरा ये दीवानापन, देखो जरा तुम हो अकेले हम भी अकेले, मजा आ
हाय
रहा है कसम से।
अश्विनी,
हाय।
आई हैव टू स्टार्ट विद वन सिंपल थिंग। हम लोग
ओह
बचपन में महात्मा गांधी की कहावत सुनते थे, उन्होंने जो कहा है, जो कोट है उनका, कि वेरी जेंटली यू कैन चेंज द वर्ल्ड। यू नो, विद दिस स्वीट लुकिंग फेस दैट यू हैव, कि देखने में ऐसा लगता है कि मतलब शी इज अ काइंड स्वीट वुमन, बट अ फॉर्मिडेबल बॉडी ऑफ वर्क एंड द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट यू आर डूइंग इन द इंडस्ट्री, अश्विनी।
आतिका, टू मच, थैंक यू।
नहीं यार, क्या टू मच। लॉकडाउन में हम जब बर्तन घिस रहे थे, आपने किताब लिख डाली, उससे पहले यू वर सिविलाइज।
मैंने भी खाना बनाया, मैंने भी बहुत घर का काम किया हुआ है लॉकडाउन में। इसके लिए मैं
अच्छा,
लिखती थी 4 से 7।
तो आपने तो मुझे पिछली बार बताया था कि आप खाना बिल्कुल नहीं बनाती हैं।
हाँ, तो फिर लॉकडाउन में सीख लिया ना मैंने। तुमने मेरे इंस्टाग्राम फोटोग्राफ्स नहीं देखे, इतने अच्छे अच्छे
आई
खाना बनाया मैंने। मैं तो
नो,
मतलब खाने में भी फोटोग्राफी ढूंढ रही थी कि कैसे मैं अच्छा फोटोग्राफ्स ले लूँ।
डायरेक्टर
हाँ,
का दिमाग, हाँ,
नहीं पर क्या करूँ, आई हैव टू मेक
बिल्कुल।
एवरीथिंग लुक नॉट बोरिंग इनफ फॉर मी।
क्रिएटिव पीपल, इवन अ प्लेट ऑफ फूड इज लाइक अ वर्क ऑफ आर्ट, द राइट कलर, द राइट टेक्सचर, द राइट प्रेजेंटेशन।
हाँ, वो उसको आप ओसीडी भी बोल सकते हो।
थोड़ा थोड़ा बीमार तो हम सब लोग हैं अश्विनी, बस ठीक है। अच्छा ये बताइए अश्विनी, कि आपने किताब लिखी है और मैंने इसको पढ़ना शुरू कर दिया है, इट्स कॉल्ड मैपिंग लव। सो वन कैन बाय अ किंडल एडिशन, वन कैन एक्चुअली ऑर्डर इट। आई ऑर्डर दिस, इट्स इन साइड, बट आई ऑल्सो हैव अ किंडल एडिशन राइट नाउ विद मी। एंड जो मैंने आपकी तस्वीरें, जो आपकी मूवीज की तस्वीरें जो बोलती हैं, दैट आर क्वाइट सिंपल एंड लाइट, बट द वर्ड्स दैट यू हैव यूज्ड आर वेरी प्रोफाउंड एंड वेरी डीप। ये कहानी कहाँ से आई और क्या ये आपकी कहानी है और इसमें
नहीं,
आपका कितना है?
नहीं नहीं, ये मेरी कहानी बिल्कुल नहीं है, क्योंकि जब आप पढ़ना चालू करोगे तो आप रियलाइज करोगे नहीं, ये मेरी कहानी बिल्कुल नहीं है। पर लेट मी टेल यू दैट, सी एज अ स्टोरी टेलर एंड आप तो, हमने काफी बातें की है एक दूसरे के साथ। आई एम क्वाइट प्रोफाउंड इवन इन माई कैरेक्टर्स इवन इट कम्स टू इवन फिल्म्स। इट्स जस्ट दैट आई गो वेरी डीप इन माई बैक स्केचेस एंड वॉट यू सी ऑन इन सिनेमा मे बी ओनली 1/4 ऑफ इट, और मे बी यू गो डीपर एंड अंडरस्टैंड द कैरेक्टर्स एंड बट द वर्क ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स हैज हैपेंड, इट्स हैपेंड ऑन पेपर, इट्स हैपेंड ऑन हाउ माई कैरेक्टर वुड लिव, ईट, टॉक, वॉट काइंड ऑफ फूड ही और शी वुड लाइक, यू नो, वॉट इज द काइंड ऑफ मूवीज दे वुड लाइक, वॉट वुड दे डू, हाउ वुड दे टॉक, हाउ वुड बी देयर रिलेशनशिप्स लाइक, आर दे वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग हेडेड, आर दे वेरी माइल्ड, डू दे थिंक फ्रॉम द हार्ट, डू दे थिंक फ्रॉम द माइंड। सो यू नो देर सो मेनी थिंग्स विच गोज इन टू अ कैरेक्टर डेवलपमेंट एंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कैरेक्टर्स विच आर डेवलप आई थिंक आर स्कार्ड, स्कार्ड इन सम वे बिकॉज ऑल ऑफ अस एज ह्यूमंस ऑल्सो आर स्कार्ड, बट वी ऑलवेज लुक फॉर अ फ्यूचरिस्टिक brightness in our lives, where even if our lives are scarred in any way, even if our character is scarred, we'll make sure that something there is always hope at the in the end, and there's always light at the end of the tunnel. So that's what I feel in even in the book which I've written. It is about these two characters called Urja and Anang, and it is about their life and from the point of view of Urja and her relationship with her parents, Anand's relationship with his parents, and the whole aspect of the relationship with nature per se, and the forest, and how the characters start intertwining themselves in the complex relationships of understanding what relationships are all about. For the longest,
What do you think? What do you think? What are relationships all about?
I think relationships are all about forgiveness. Relationships are all about a love between a man and a woman, not per se. It can be with anyone. The relationship between a parent and a child at any age changes, keeps changing. And most of the time we feel that the husband understands the wife, or the wife understands the husband very well, or a sister-brother understands each other very well, or a guy and a girl understand each other very well. But how much do we really understand them? Is for us to ask ourselves. And at the end of the day, we all have to go up. And it is important that in this course of life, we don't carry all this emotional baggage with us. And therefore, forgiveness plays a very important role in the story. And for me, I do feel that I keep giving this example that our emotions are like a garbage, you know, and bad emotions, if you carry it along in a garbage and you keep putting it in a garbage can, what will happen? It will start overflowing one day. And when it starts overflowing, then you mess up your relationships. We mess up a whole lot of aspects of what could have been altered, but didn't get altered for whatever reason. So I feel that the aspect of forgiveness and the aspect of relooking at the whole pathway to the end, because an end will come for each one of us. So, but the pathway to the end should be.
बर्तन में जहर रखा हुआ होता है, उस बर्तन को ही जहर सबसे ज्यादा नुकसान पहुंचाता है. तो अगर वो सारी नफरत आपने अपने अंदर रखी हुई है, तो ये समझिए कि सबसे ज्यादा नुकसान आप ही का हो रहा है. And I thought that that's a good way of looking at it. और हाँ, there was a nice video that says कि आपने पिछले संडे को क्या खाना खाया था, क्या ये आपको याद है? नहीं याद है तो ये बताइए कि 10 साल पहले आपको किसी ने क्या बुरी बात बोल दी थी, ये आपको क्यों याद है? So very logical, but it needs that one book or one video to make us realize that.
Right. Yeah.
आपका दिन किसने रुकाया था?
Yes, a lot of things. Yeah. I think we all are very emotional people. We think from the heart. We sometimes make wrong judgments about people. And there would be times when you think that it's the right thing to do. But then in the course of time, you feel it was not actually the right thing. So these kind of things happen. And it's only important to take it on your stride. And but the one thing which I've learned in my whole course of life is, especially I think we understand these things when we're slightly more mature in our mind and in terms of what we think and how we look at life, is that it is important not to carry any grudges, and it's important to just let go and just move on and forgive.
तो अश्विनी, मैं ना कुछ आपसे रैंडम सवाल पूछना चाहती हूँ, इसलिए क्योंकि मैंने बहुत सारे डायरेक्टर्स, बहुत सारे एक्टर्स से बहुत सारी बातचीतें की हैं, लेकिन मुझे आपका जो डीएनए है और जो आपका सोचने का तरीका है, वो थोड़ा यूनिक लगता है. आपकी फिल्म मेकिंग थोड़ी यूनिक है. एक तो ये दैट यू मेक मूवीज अराउंड वुमेन, बट दे आर नॉट हाइपर फेमिनिस्टिक थीम्स. यू नो, इट्स नॉट अबाउट माई बॉडी, आई डू व्हाटएवर आई वांट टू डू, यू कांट सी मी, यू कांट टच मी. You know, मुझे नया sometimes feminism also can be a little disturbing to equalists, जो आदमी और औरत में बराबरी देखते हैं. वो नहीं है आपका, बड़ा ही democratic और बहुत ही non-judgmental approach है towards gender equality. सबसे पहले तो ये बताइए अश्विनी कि growing up, you are an ayer. You know, मैं अपने कई दोस्तों से बोलती हूँ कि मुझे बहुत अफसोस है इस बात का कि मैं दो तरह के लोगों से जिंदगी में बहुत लेट मिली. ओनली व्हेन आई वाज 21 एंड आई स्टार्टेड स्टडीइंग इन दिल्ली इन अ कॉलेज, आई रियलाइज्ड आई मेट अप विद बंगाली एंड स्टेड इन अ हॉस्टल विद देम एंड साउथ इंडियंस, यू नो, मलयालीज एंड पीपल फ्रॉम डाउन साउथ, हैदराबादीज. एंड आई रियलाइज्ड दैट आई शुड हैव मेट मलयालीज एंड बंगालीज वे अर्ली इन लाइफ, because they are so liberal and they are so ahead of time, so modern, So different, you know, as opposed to just the North Indian culture that we have grown up with. You tell me about the family that you grew in. You are a Matunga girl, you are a Mumbai girl who knows Bareilly and Meerut equally well. You are a woman who doesn't judge characters, doesn't judge people, who has a very sweet and a kind take on all kinds of world, you know. अगर आप नॉर्थ इंडिया की सेटिंग दिखा भी रही हैं तो आप मर्दों को हार्श और ब्रैश नहीं दिखाते हैं। आई वॉन्ट टू नो आपका बचपन कैसा था और आपके माँ बाप क्या करते थे और आपके सिबलिंग्स क्या करते थे।
So, I'm the only child of my parents, and I grew up in this very small place, which is the end of Mumbai. उसके बाद थाना आता है, थाने आता है, which is basically मुलुंड. And मुलुंड को वो टाइम पे मुखिल स्टेशन बोला जाता था, because I think वो before इंडिपेंडेंस और उसके बाद it was like a hill station which had a lot of mountains, and the mountain is the one which shares with बोरीवली. तो बोरीवली नेशनल पार्क और मुलुंड का जो डिवीजन है वो एक माउंटेन है उधर. सो आई ग्रो अप इन दिस वेरी स्मॉल प्लेस एंड वेंट टू अ स्कूल फॉर सेंट मेरीज कॉन्वेंट एंड माय मदर हैज बीन अ स्कूल प्रिंसिपल फॉर एवर. सो एंड माय फादर इज अ पीएचडी इन प्लांट पैथोलॉजी. सो बेसिकली आई हैव ग्रोन अप अमंग्स प्लांट्स एंड माइक्रोस्कोप्स एंड ग्रोइंग.
Wow.
Like he has grown potatoes in Saudi Arabia in the desert. So basically, that's the kind of growing up years. And also, I think the interest in music and I was learned I learned Bharatnatyam. I did my Arangetam in Bharatnatyam. Then I learned classical music. And I did 6 years of classical music, after which I left.
Wow.
And Hindustani classical I did. And I think my mother always wanted me to be in the creative arts, but being like a middle class family, we always go more towards, get studying and then getting a degree in that matter, which would tick mark all the liabilities we would have. Is because I started working also very early. I was funding my art school along with my
Wow.
college and working in an events company and doing all kinds of art there and
But
even on the side.
that was not because your parents lacked money, because both your parents were doing very well in life. So why were you
No,
funding
I
them?
would say that in between there was this little gap where my father had lost his job and my mother was doubling up in terms of taking classes, coaching classes, and also tutions, and also studying and doing things. So that was there, but that I think those kind of setbacks always make you more resilient and always makes you want to work harder and do your own thing.
Wow.
So I started working very early is because I was supposed to be a CA because my mama is a CA and I was supposed to do my CA, but I think I failed very badly in class 12 in maths. And I still remember it was October 2nd, and you opened this whole conversation by Gandhiji. And I remember on October 2nd, some 27, 28 years back, I told my mother, I'm done with 12th, I'm done with CA, I'm done with everything. I can't do this, I can't do maths, I can't do any of those things. I want to do art. I want to be a painter. I want to be an artist. And she told me, "Ho, ho, how can we middle class people be painters? We do not know how to sell paintings. We can't do business." And
Wow.
I said that, "No, but I do not know anything, but I need to do something about this." And he was very nice. And my uncle is an IIT professor in IIT Mumbai, was an IIT professor in Mumbai. So we kind of understood the whole thing. And IIT had IDC, which is Industrial Design Center. So he spoke to some of his professor friends and he said that, you know what, even you can be an artist and even you can earn money. So basically, we let her do her commercial arts. So I wanted to actually go to NID, but NID at that point of time was too expensive for me because it was 70,000 for the whole year, which was very expensive for me. And I said, okay, so I will apply in JJ School of Arts and I'll apply in Sophia Polytechnic. And I got into Sophia Polytechnic. And I worked and studied for 5 years. It was camera, colors, research. There's so much you do when you're in art school. But I learned a lot there and I majored in typography and calligraphy and photography as my major. And I passed out as a gold medalist, and I got a direct placement in Leuvenet at that point of time. So yes, I would give hats off to my mother who guided me, saying that, okay, you want to be an artist, but be an artist who will earn money. So for me, the best thing was to do, okay. So I would have either joined a publishing house, like the Times of India Group, or, you know, or designing and illustrating pages, or I would have joined an ad agency. I got a job in an ad agency, and I think that was the best decision I took. And from there, it was just a journey right from the beginning. So I started off with designing ads. I've done big print campaigns for a lot of brands, and then slowly and steadily started telling stories through film medium and writing for radio, and then started heading the agency Mumbai as an ACD. Yeah, and then Nilbati Samadhan.
Actually, as a woman growing up as a girl, was the world tough on you, harsh on you? Because some women directors have really very, very rough stories to tell. You know, you talk to Guneet, many of my female film directors or writers have a lot of angst in them. Aatika Chauhan, who wrote Chapaak, has many stories to say. CEO of Censor Board, Pankaja Thakur, she's from Bihar, a lot of stories. You know, what's your struggle? Did you see struggle as a girl?
I would not say struggle as a growing up girl, is because I was fortunate enough to grow up in Mumbai, which already had a lot of openings for many women to follow their passion of work. So I was blessed that way. And also, I think I joined advertising, which anyways had a lot of women out there at that point of time. And I had a lot of clients of mine right across a lot of multinational brands who I used to work with across Asia. And there were many women there. So I didn't understand the idea of growing up as a girl, of what kind of choices do I need to make with my career? Because I was always told in my household that you need to study, you need to make money, you need to work, you need to make money, you need to get married, you also need to have children, and at the same time you need to continue your work. So it was always that. And it was also that you need to read a lot, you need to listen to a lot of music. So I've heard Mozart and MS Subbalakshmi, and I've learned, wow, I've understood Carnatic music, and I know Hindustani classical music. So I've grown up with all those kind of different aspects. Like my aunt, my father's younger sister are all Carnatic kacheri singers, you know, they do kacheri in Chennai. So we have grown up around this kind of atmosphere. So I would not say that was a challenge. But if you are saying that after I joined advertising, there would be places where you would have colleagues, or sometimes you would have also clients who would never look into your eye and speak to you because you're a decision maker, or the challenges which will come in when you want to go home early, and maybe because of the prototype you just want to finish your work, you want to do everything on time, and you want to leave from work and go home, or whatever you want to do after office hours. And there was no midnight dinners for me. So in terms that, you know, working late and all that never happened in my scheme of things. So I didn't understand that culture, which comes from a very which comes, I think, would be like, you know, a very male groupism kind of thing, which also changed after time. So I would not understand that. In fact, we were encouraged in our agencies by our bosses to hire more women in the team, to tell more stories which have women as protagonists. So we were always encouraged to do that. But the change which I saw was when I joined films, is because I was not looked at the way I would want to be looked at. to be called sir is not a joke, like to be called and not to be looked into the eye. And when I've gone for a recce and I've been, and someone is looking at me and not looking at me, but looking at my production person or someone else or my AD and looking at him and talking. And when I could literally look and say, hello.
Yeah, look at me and talk.
Look to me. I'm the decision maker. I'm going to be taking the calls here. So, you know, so that's what it was. And, but things change. I've also always been a person. I remember giving a TEDx talk in Infi Bangalore, and the whole conversation was had to have the yin and the yang. I do feel that it is very
important.
I have a very strong mind in terms of what I want to achieve, what I want to do in life, and what kind of respect I seek. And I also am a very, I see things as black and white in terms of respect. And if I'm not getting respect somewhere, I would let that person know. If someone has sent a mail to me saying, dear sir, and then talking about work, I would very happily reply back and say, first learn to acknowledge that you who you're speaking to and what work you want, and then let's talk further. So I'm very honest and direct about those things when it comes to respect. Because and also I'm extremely sure about my journey and my work. So I think it's important for women to understand and love their personality and their work, which they get to the table. To when they start respecting themselves and their work is when others will start respecting you. I always believe in that. So I've never had issues in terms of this pay parity or any of those sorts, is because I very quietly done what is important and what is right for the work. So in the same case, there would be a lot of directors who are men who would not get the right opportunities. But it always comes down to the women, is because we think that we have not got the opportunities because our gender talks about it. But I don't think so. That is the case. We have changed the system with respect to our work and workspace.
And you're a very sweet looking, you would rather pass off as a South Indian actress. You have that ultra feminine outlook.
Wow. So are you asking me now to go to Tamil movies and start acting there? You know, my mother had this dream. She told me that, why don't you go? At that point of time, so 25 years ago, she told me, why don't you go to Chennai and, you know, why don't you start acting in some movies and all
that? Yeah, yeah, you can. You have learned. Think of song now. Think of song.
No. No.
Please.
Hey, Atika, no.
Please, yaar. You sung. यार जो सीखा हुआ है वो ना जा सके, हम लोग भी कहीं कहीं भी शुरू हो जाते हैं. आपको तो कोई रिक्वेस्ट करे तो यू आर ऑब्लाइज्ड, यू शुड बी ऑब्लाइज्ड टू सिंग. कम ऑन,
मेरे को वर्ड्स नहीं आते यार आधा टाइम.
तो जितना आता उतना सुना दो मेरी जान.
हंसोगी तो नहीं?
नहीं यार.
गुस्सा तो नहीं करोगी बाद में? ये तो
नहीं यार.
आ जाएगा ना. ओके चलो, मैंने अभी खोला. मेरे को आई होप भूमि मार ना दे मेरे को इसके बाद. ओके. मोह मोह के धागे, मोह मोह के धागे, ये मोह मोह के धागे तेरी उंगलियों से जा उलझे. कोई तोह तोह ना लागे, किस तरह गिरहा ये सुलझे. है रोम रोम एक तारा, है रोम रोम एक तारा, जो बादलों में से गुजरे.
फिर से उठाइए. मैजिक कर दूँगी.
नहीं बस.
Come on.
तुम भी गाओ मेरे साथ. हाँ.
मेरी आवाज बैठी है लेकिन मैं गाती हूँ।
ये मोह मोह के धागे तेरी उंगलियों से जाए, कोई तो है तो लागे इस तरह गिर तुझे, तू होगा जरा पागल तूने मुझको है चुना, तू होगा जरा पागल तूने मुझको है चुना। कैसे बस हाँ अभी यहाँ बहुत
कैसे
नहीं, अनु मलिक जी ने बहुत अच्छा इसके गाने और लिरिक्स भी बहुत अच्छे लिखे, मैं इसका कुछ करना नहीं चाहती हूँ, बस मैं इतना ही गा पाऊंगी। एक टाइम पे ना वो वाला गाना गाती बहुत गाती थी आतिका, ये तो कट जाएगा तो फिर कटने दे, जब पता है ये सब स्कूल कॉम्पिटिशन्स में गाने होते थे, गाने की कॉम्पिटिशन होती थी तो सब जगह तो जाना पड़ता है ना, नहीं तो ये जब गणपति के जो होता है तो वहां पे वो 10 days में जो होती है ना जो कॉलोनी सब जाता था, तो ये वाला बहुत इजी होता था तो मैं हमेशा गाती थी कयामत से कयामत का ये वाला गाना, गजब का है दिन, गजब का है दिन सोचो जरा ये दीवानापन, देखो जरा तुम हो अकेले हम भी अकेले, मजा आ रहा है कसम से, देख लो हमको करीब से, आज हम मिले हैं नसीब से। ओ, जिस तरह से ना आमिर सर और जूही मैम ऐसे वो घूमते थे ना वो पूरे ऐसे, it's like just that, the whole song is just that scene and with the huge coniferous trees and the barks and it's just that, it's so beautiful, it's so simple, that's
all. I think ये बताइए सनी कि romantic एक समा भी बन गया है, मैपिंग लव की बात भी हो रही है, तो आपकी लाइफ का जो लव है अय्यर वर्सेस तिवारी ये कैसे हुआ?
नितेश वाज वर्किंग इन लो लिंटास, व्हिच वाज लिंटास बिफोर नाउ लो, एंड आई वाज इन लियो बिनेट एंड वी हैड दिस I had this really dear friend called Priyanka, and he had a friend still his really dear friend called Gautam, who is an MX player now. Gautam will kill me if I tell this. And so ek din humne bahut kaam kar liya tha, and my copy partner who is now heading ONM, she's the chief creative officer, Kenaz. So Kenaz and Nitesh had worked in a previous agency called Ulka a long time back, before they came into Leo Burnett. So Kenaz, once in a conference when we were having a conversation, told that, you know, I have this really dear friend of mine who's written like superb radios and all that. And you should hear this radio. It's really nice, very well-written radio. And got the, like, you know, the whole insight really well. So I was like, okay, and all that. And then the same evening, we were like too tired working. And Priyanka told me that, you want to come with me because I have, you know, got them there and his friends from Loa coming. So you can join me for dinner. Then she introduced me to him and he was playing pool. And I also started playing pool. And I think that's we just met and बस उसके बाद मिलते रहे, और फिर मम्मी को बोला मैंने कि नितेश के साथ
तिवारी है।
हाँ तो she was like हाँ but advertising and all that, you know, क्यों करना है तुमको, and I said नहीं नहीं वो IIT का इंजीनियर है, तो अचानक ऐसा सब दिमाग चेंज हो गया बिकॉज माई अंकल वॉज अ प्रोफेसर इन IIT मुंबई, सो इट वॉज हिज प्रोफेसर, सो यू नो ऑल दैट,
ऐसी एक्चुअली तो आपकी शादी हो गई, ठीक है. नाउ आप दोनों एडवर्टाइजिंग में काम कर रहे हैं एंड देन यू हैव टू बेबीज ऑल्सो. ये संचलन कैसे बैठता है? बिकॉज यू आर अ फ्रीक्वेंट ट्रैवलर, यू आर अ परफेक्शनिस्ट, यू आर एम्बिशियस, यू वॉन्ट टू डू सो मेनी थिंग्स एंड यू हैव डन देम परफेक्टली एंड विद किड्स एंड कैसे कैसे आर यू अ बिग फैन ऑफ डेलीगेटिंग वर्क और यू आर अ वेरी गुड प्लानर? वॉट इज द ट्रिक?
I think I'm a good planner, and also I don't think so. I like delegating work, but sometimes I like doing a lot of things on my own also. And but I think it's a more multitasking and more planning kind of thing. And I also prioritize, so I don't. Like to be everywhere in terms of that. If there are some things, I think it's a societal norm that you need to be as a mother, as a especially who wants to do a lot of things in life. She has to be everywhere and be responsible for everything. I don't think so. I take that kind of stress, and I don't feel guilty about it either. So that is something I think works for me, and I can detach myself also very easily. So yes, I like my work. I like doing my creative work, but at the same time I can completely detach myself. And maybe, and it's happened, if you see my Instagram timelines, they would be like for 1 month I've not even been there. And even now, like right now I'm there every day because it's important, but then I'll be just one day switch off and say bus and then I'll be gone. So wow. I have that capability to do that. Yeah.
और अगर कुछ मूवीज आप सजेस्ट करेंगी जो आपने लॉकडाउन में देखी और आप चाहते हैं कि सब जरूर देखें जस्ट टू नर्चर देयर सोल, वो कौन सी होगी? एक्चुअली
देयर आर लॉट ऑफ मूवीज. आई ऑनेस्टली अतिका एंड दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच नितेश मुझे हमेशा बहुत चढ़ाता है मुझे, बट आई वॉच लेस ऑफ फिल्म्स, आई रीड अ लॉट. आई एम अ मोर ऑफ एन एविड रीडर एंड टुमारो इफ यू एवर इंटरव्यू नितेश और स्पीक टू हिम ही विल टेल यू द सेम थिंग. I watch lesser films. For me, my imagination of making films comes from my own experiences and what I like. I don't like to take references always, but yeah, if you want me to say that abhi ye kaun si films dekhni chahiye, main bata abhi aap mujhe bata de kaun si book padhni chahiye, main abhi aapko bata dungi. But kaun si film dekhni chahiye, to mujhe aisa lagta hai ki definitely going back, we should watch Good Will Hunting, we should watch Pursuit of Happiness, we should watch
Life is Beautiful.
We should watch even our comedy films of Sai Paranjpe, slice of life films of Rishikesh Hatha. We should go and rewatch all these films. We should watch Izazat. We should watch there's so many beautiful films we have. Yeah. We should also watch, because now subtitles are available, we should really watch some really nice old Tamil films, some very nice Malayalam films which are there, which are very, very beautiful, and also some very, very beautiful Marathi films which are there.
That's true. Visual cinema has some real hidden gems.
And very beautiful Bengali films are there. Yeah.
Absolutely.
There's this beautiful film in Marathi called Mayrechi Sadi, which should be watched. In Tamil, there's this movie, I'm sure everyone knows about it. It's Michael Madan Kamarajan, which is like really very funny. But it's so beautifully made and what amazing acting.
Wow.
Should be watched.
Aapne bhi to apni Nilvate Sannata Tamil mein phir se banayi thi, na?
Yeah.
In Tamil. Wow. So say something in Tamil.
What do you want me to say?
Anything, yeah. I like
tell
learning.
Me what do you want to say?
Okay, my name is Atika.
Enoda peyar Atika.
Enoda
peyar Atika.
Enoda peyar Atika. Okay.
Today I have too much of work. Today you have too much of work. Today I have too much of work. You say na, don't disturb me now. Today you have too much of work.
Don't disturb me. Today I have too much of work.
Enna disturb pannade nare vele irukku iniki. So to, when someone doesn't want to understand, you just say, "Disturb, but I'm not really here."
comedy films. Your comic timing is very good.
No, because I think I've grown in, born and brought up in Mumbai, and I've lived around so many multilingual people that I picked up also languages, because I had Marathi in Hindi in school. I speak very good Marathi is because I've dealt with so many, all my friends and agencies, art directors and all.
Yeah.
So I understand the language very well. I like learning languages, but Bengali I understand, but I cannot speak. This is one language which I want to learn now.
Yeah. Oh yes.
Gujarati,
oh,
yes. Kachi.
Maro naam Atika che. Ashwani maro dost.
Maro naam su che.
Bau gamit che.
Ashwani maro Atika che. Bau gamit che.
Ashwani mani bau.
Mari dost che. Haan, mari dost che.
Mani
ko bau gamyu.
Ashwani mane bau gamyu
che. Gamyu. Gamyu.
Bau gamyu. That is the beauty of art, yeah. And in the end, Ashwani, ye bataiye ki jab aap you work with Sangna, you work with Swara, you work with so many different kinds of actors. What actors are fun to work with for a director? Are treat to work with for a director?
I have been extremely blessed to have all my actors across my short films, my feature films, my ad films. I would say more of short films and feature films because there you spend a lot of time with your actors and very established actors. I've been very blessed that all my actors have surrendered to me in totality in terms of trusting me and, you know, giving their 100% of their time and sensibilities to me and trusting me for the fact that they know that whatever I do for them, whether all my actors, male or female, actors and female actors, that I would do the best for them. And there's no other motivation for me. I always feel, I think that's my starting point, that when my actors shine, I just feel very proud about that. I just feel a sense of pride.
You know, I surrendered to my director, and I actually acted in a Netflix film with Manoj Bajpayee, directed by Abhishek Chaubey.
Oh, nice!
Yes! And
finally!
You know, And you know, I have an angel at home who's invisible and who can tell me future. Wait.
Yeah, so We will.
When I work with Ashwini? He says our film will be out in the next 1 year.
You never know, Artika. The future is always very bright, and of course I've connected with you for something else also long time back, so yes, I will 100%. I've told you that.
Yeah, on the record aa gaya hai ab to.
No, of course.
So great mapping love.
My joy is to find new talent and to give them wings. I just feel, like I said before, mujhe bahut maza aata hai usme.
Ashwini, thank you so much. You are such a great talent that we have. Aapki movies dekhkar itna acha lagta hai. They are not trying to make a point. They are just great fun. And I must tell you, I think I told you ki bahut saalon mein mere father ne movie hall jaake Dil Bate Sannata dekhi thi. Raat ke 11 baje ka show Gore Gaon mein. Aur wo 4-5 din tak uski baat karte rahe the mujhse. Wo bahut achhi thi film. And we need to get that innocence back in our cinema, in our movies. Which should be for everybody to enjoy, people of all ages. And wo aap bana rahi hain, aise hi kaam karte rahiye, kitabein padhte rahiye, have your own imagination and make good cinema.
Thank you so much.